Hello and welcome to the design of machine elements course. We are dealing with unit number 5 on belt drives. So initially we will see here the content of this particular unit by looking over its syllabus. So this unit consists of first of all the belt drive, and the different contents of this belt drive are as specified here on this slide, starting with the materials and construction of the flat belt, V belts, to the finally application of the timing belts like that. Then there are wire ropes, where they are expecting only the relevant treatment of these wire ropes, considering the construction of wire ropes, layout of wire ropes, stresses in wire ropes and all this. And then there will be chain drives. So first we will start with this belt drives. So here basically there are two types of drives. One is a rigid drive, which is, you can see here, like a gear drive is there, and a flexible drive, which can be a belt, rope or chain drive. So in case of a rigid drive, there is a direct contact between the die ring and the driven shaft through pinion and the gear. It means the rotary motion of the pinion is being transferred to the rotary motion of the gear. So direct contact is there in case of this rigid drive, while in case of a flexible drive, the input shaft or the input pulley is transferring its motion through an intermediate link. That intermediate link may be belt, rope or a chain, and from this particular intermediate link, then it is given to the output shaft or the output pulley. So in case of flexible drive, the rotary motion is of the pulley is transferred into a translatory motion of the flexible element, which may be belt, rope or chain, and this translatory motion of the belt, rope or chain is converted again into rotary motion of the output shaft. So this is what is the basic difference between the rigid and the flexible drive. So rigid drive can be used when the center distance between the two shafts is small or less, and when it is very large distance, when you have to transfer the power over a longer distances, then you have to use this kind of flexible drive. So this flexible drive will absorb the shocks and it will damp the vibrations. Also, the flexibility in location of the driving and the driven shaft is also better in this particular type of drive compared to this rigid drive. And this flexible drive is also quite cheap. But the problem is that it will occupy more space, and also the velocity ratio, which is being maintained constant in case of rigid drive, that cannot be maintained constant in case of a flexible drive. So we will just go into the more details about this belt drives. So generally these belt drives are used in conveyors, mostly called as conveying systems. So for the transportation of the different products in the industries, maybe transportation of the coal in the power plants or in sugar factories, so or mineral oils, etc., over a long distance, baking machinery, brick and clay machinery. So many applications are there in which these conveying systems are used. Similarly, these are used for transmission of power. So mainly it is used for running of various industrial appliances using prime motors like electric motor. So most of the time we are using electric motor as a prime mover, and then it is needed to transfer the motion from this electric motor to the machinery, industrial machinery, or maybe to the from the IC engines, you are transferring the power to some machinery. So there is use of this belt drives or flexible drives for transferring the power, and many a times these are used as a replacement of the rigid type of power transmission. So gear drive may be replaced by a belt transmission system in some applications. So definitely these flexible drives can absorb a good amount of shock and vibration. And if there is some misalignment between the input and the output shaft, then also it will take care of that. And specifically it is used for transferring the motion over a long distance. And therefore we will see that how a belt drive can be used here in case of a diesel engine also for power transmission. So let us discuss about different advantages of the belt drive one by one. So if you try to design this belt, actually it is very easy to design, because there is only one flexible element which is having certain cross section. So mostly if it's a flat belt, so it's having a rectangular cross section, and if it is a V belt, it is having a trapezoidal cross section. So, or if it is a round belt, it is a circular cross section. So that cross section of the belt is required to be designed, and mostly the this particular cross section of the belt is subject to tensile stress. So only under tension actually you have to design this particular belt, and therefore you can see that design is very simple. So it means if you know the maximum amount of tensile force is going to act over this particular belt, so we can design it very easily by considering the allowable tensile stress. And it is also not required that shafts in between which you are going to transfer the power, they should be exactly parallel. So there is some misalignment. If it is there, it will also work properly. At the same time, if there is any overload, it means when sometimes very high torque acts by the some machinery over the machine or the motor, so that time it will not jam. So in short, that it will slip, and therefore we will get the overload and jam protection. At the same time, the noise and vibrations are less, or it will be damped in this kind of drive, and therefore it is being very quiet operation is there. At the same time, the life of the machinery is more, as in case of gears we need to provide the lubrication because there is a direct contact between these two, so such kind of requirement is not there in case of belt drive. So it is completely lubrication free, and it requires a very low maintenance, but at the same time it is very efficient. Even though it is being transferring the power with the help of friction, because friction is the main, so by friction even though transmission is there, but still you will get the very good efficiency in power transmission. And as we already discussed that the misalignment, if it is there, it will be tolerable here. And when the power is to be transmitted over a very large distances, in that case this is the only one option which is an economical one. Now, as there are certain advantages of the belt drive, there may be some disadvantages with this. So what are the disadvantages are? So first of all, the space required for this kind of drive is more. Second thing is that the angular velocity ratio will not be maintained constant. Okay, and the ratio of pulley diameters will also will not be maintained constant because of the belt slip and the stretch which occurs in case of a belt drive. So one more thing is that the arrangement of the belt drive is such that it is going to provide heavy loads on the shaft, and due to friction there is a heat built up also occurs, and therefore we are going to limit the speed of this so that more heat will not get built up into this particular system. So maximum speed is limited to 35 meter per second, and also power transmission is also limited to 370 kilowatt, not more than that. At the same time, it is seen that the operating temperature should be maintained between minus 35 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius. Okay, and in some cases some adjustment of center distance or use of an idler pulley is necessary for wear and stretch compensation, while a means of disassembly must be provided to install the endless belt, because most of the time the belts are endless, so we have to change the center distance, means you have to pull these two pulleys towards each other and mount the belt and again extend these pulleys away from each other, so that the required tension will be maintained into the belt for power transmission. And there is a loss of power, and life is also quite less. Now we will see the different types of belt cross sections. So in this here you can see this is the flat belt drive where there is a cross section of the belt is a rectangular one. Then there can be a V belt where the trapezoidal shape of the belt is belt cross section is specified here. This is nothing but the top width of the belt, this is the belt thickness, and this is the included belt angle, that is V belt angle. While sometimes you are using the timer belts also, which will be having this flat belt on the top side, and inside it there will be such teeth are provided. This is called as timer belt. So accordingly the cavities are there on the pulley for inserting this particular timer belt over that particular pulley. And in this case you can see the round belt where the cross section is a round one. Now we will go for the understanding the belt drive. So a belt is a looped strip of flexible material used to mechanically link two or more rotating shafts. So they may be used as a source of motion to efficiently transmit power or to track relative movement. So belts are looped over pulleys. In a two pulley system, the belt can either drive the pulleys in the same direction or the belt may be crossed. So the direction of shaft is opposite. So when the direction is same, it is called as open belt drive, and when the belt is crossed, it is called as cross belt drive. So in case of open belt, the driver and driven will be having same rotation, while in case of crossed belt, it is driver and driven will be rotating in opposite direction. So velocity ratio of up to 4:1 can be used in a belt drive. So here you can see the belt drive in which it is actually open belt drive. So this is pulley 1, which is a driving pulley, where you indicating as 1, and this is driven pulley. Okay, so now the direction of rotation of this driving pulley is in the clockwise direction here, and this is also rotating in the clockwise direction. So there is a belt specified here over this two pulleys. So belt is having certain thickness T, and this is nothing but the angle of contact between the belt and the pulley, that is specified as a angle of wrap or angle of contact theta. Similarly, this is the, on this side also there is a contact of this belt over the pulley. Then this pulley 2 and pulley 1 is at a distance of C, that is nothing but the shaft spacing or center distance between the two pulleys. So if we have to find out the length of belt required for this kind of open belt drive, then we will consider certain notations here. So suppose if we consider this DL, which is the larger pulley diameter, and DS is the diameter of the smaller pulley. This is, and alpha L is the angle of wrap of the larger pulley, and alpha S is the angle of wrap of the smaller pulley. So alpha S and alpha L. So definitely angle of wrap for the larger pulley is more, and for smaller pulley it will be less because of the this diameter difference, diameter ratio. So C is the center distance between the two pulleys. Now basic formula is like, suppose you have to calculate alpha L. So definitely this is 180 degree here from here to your half circle, plus this angle and plus this angle. So if I call this angle as beta, so it will be 180 plus 2 beta. And for smaller pulley, this is 180 minus this and this, that is this 2 beta. So 180 minus 2 beta for smaller pulley, this one, where beta is to be calculated by sine inverse of DL minus DS by 2C. Because if I to calculate this angle beta, so I will just drop one line here. Suppose from this radius, if I drop one line like this parallel, so now this line is perpendicular to this line, and this particular line is perpendicular to this line. So this angle is also nothing but the beta. So this distance means, if I have to find out the sine of this, so front side by hypotenuse, so front side is nothing but DL means this actually it is diameter of larger pulley minus diameter of smaller pulley. So actually it is a radius of this, I mean DL minus DC by 2. So it will be, this distance will be DL minus DS by 2. So this is front side of this particular angle beta. And hypotenuse of this is nothing but the C. So we are calculating this beta is equal to sine inverse of DL minus DS by 2C. Okay, similarly, then once you get this beta, you can find out this alpha, this angle of wrap for smaller pulley and larger pulley, by taking the addition or subtraction of this 2 beta term with 180. And now if you have to find out the length of belt, so definitely for calculating the length of belt, we need this length, means this arc length, plus this arc length. So first of all, these two arc lengths are considered. So it is pi into DL plus DS by 2. means this pi d is the circumference of this particular pi into dl is the circumference of this particular pulley and circumference of this pulley. So I need half circumference of this side, half circumference of this side. So it is pi into dl plus ds by 2 plus 2c. So this distance I want and this distance I want. So this 1c, this another c plus 2c plus the small difference over here, because I am considering the straight lines distances. So actually it is inclined, these two pulleys are having different diameters. So one more additional term will be there, which is equal to 1 upon 4c dl minus ds bracket square. So this is nothing but the length of open belt drive. Similarly, we can see the cross belt drive. So in case of cross belt drive, the direction of rotation of this pulley is anti-clockwise. Suppose if it is a driving pulley, so this pulley will be rotating in clockwise direction, that is driven pulley. So that is basically the difference between these two. And at the same time, you will find out that as it is a cross belt arrangement, you will find there is a requirement of more length compared to the open belt drive. So in this case, the DL, DS are nothing but the diameters of these pulleys. Alpha is nothing but the angle of wrap. Same notations are there. So in this case, you will find out that the angle of contact for a larger pulley and angle of contact for the smaller pulley, it is equal. So that is, it is 180 plus 2 beta on this side also, and 180 plus 2 beta on this side also. So alpha S and alpha L will be same for the cross belt drive, and beta is being calculated as sine inverse of dl minus ds by 2c. Why the length of cross belt? So we considered here pi by 2 into dl plus ds by 2, so half perimeter of this plus half perimeter of this plus 2c like in the previous case, plus 1 by 4c dl plus ds bracket square. So because of this cross belt arrangement, here there is a plus sign. Well, in case of open belt drive, we have considered that minus sign here, while it is to be considered as plus sign. That is only the difference in the calculating the length of belt for the cross belt drive. So definitely this will be larger compared to the your open belt drive. Now we will talk about the belt tensions. So suppose if it is your driving pulley and if it is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, okay, so generally it is seen that the tight side tension should act on the bottom side, and for that, according to that, actually you have to take the direction of rotation of that pulley on the driven side. Because if you take the in the reverse way, suppose if you take it is in the clockwise direction, so what will happen, tight side tension will go on the top and here it will be slack side tension. So because you are using this tight side tension over here and slack side tension on the top side, you can increase the angle of contact of this particular pulley. Because if the tight side, if you make it is anti-clockwise direction like this, and the belt will be pulled in this direction, and therefore this side will be having tension, and here that belt will be pushed from the pulley. So definitely there is a sagging will occur, and because of the sagging, the contact angle will increase over here, and that is beneficial. So more is the contact angle, so accordingly more will be the power transmission that we will get. Similarly, we can see here the friction on pulley and friction on belt. So forces acting on the belt and the pulley are shown over here. So as the pulley is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, say it is driver, so over that in the opposite direction there will be the force will act. While for the driven, because power is transferred from this particular pulley to this belt, so this is the force acting on the belt, so this will move in the anti-clockwise direction. Similarly, now this is nothing but a driver and now this is a driven. So over this belt, now the power is the force acting over here is in the opposite direction to the, and this is a driven one, so in this case it is in the direction of this particular pulley. So power will be transferred from the pulley to the belt, from this belt to the pulley, and always your tight side tension will be more than the slack side tension. Okay, so now we will see there is a centrifugal tension due to the belt material.